Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel, and if you're new, welcome. My name is Zoe. Most people know me as ZA Reptiles, and for those of you that already follow me or subscribe to me or watch my videos, as you can see, I am officially moved. I have moved in to my parents' house, into my sister's old bedroom. It's been quite the process, moving a whole apartment back into my parents' house, fitting all my animals into this little bedroom because my sister took my bedroom once I moved out. So it was a good process, but I did it. All the animals are in here. I have a bed. I got all my clothes to fit in the closet because I don't have room for any furniture. Mission accomplished. You can see my hair is a little different since I don't have to pay rent or bills anymore. I spoiled myself and let myself get my hair done because I usually do it every year during Thanksgiving break, but I couldn't afford to do it during Thanksgiving break this year. So now that I'm home, I got a moving check and I'm getting a couple more checks from the zoo. I splurged. Should I let myself get my hair done? So this is just step one. I've actually had burgundy hair before in the past, and then I switched over to doing like ombre over my natural hair. And I was ready for a change again. But I really like both styles, so we're just gonna combine the two. So step one is the burgundy. And then a couple days after Christmas, I'm gonna go back and we're gonna do like the caramely blonde ombre over it. It looks very dark because I just got it done yesterday, so I haven't washed it yet since getting it done. So after I wash it, it usually lightens up quite a bit. So for right now, it's still pretty dark. So I'm trying my hardest to get everything organized and set to do a Herpmas room tour for you guys at my new place of residence, but I don't know if I'll get it done before Christmas, but I'm trying. I'm really, really trying. Otherwise, you'll get a room tour in January, but I really am trying to get one in for Herpmas. But until that is ready, we're gonna keep going with Herpmas videos. So today's video is going to be my epic wish list when it comes to herps. So I did a video like this last year for Zoomis, but I pretty much just rambled through my list of all the animals I could ever want. This list is just gonna be my top 10. My top 10 dream herps. The herps that I really, 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 really want. And it's not gonna be exactly the same from the list I made last year because it's been a year. Things have changed. There are animals on that list that I now own, so they're not on that list anymore. So one of the animals that was on that list was a milk snake like Zero. I wanted a milk snake. This is what I was actively looking for at the time that I filmed this video last year, was a milk snake that was red, black, and white. And shortly after, maybe a couple months later, I found him. So he's gonna join us for this video today because he was involved in this video last year, whether he knew it or not. So I'm just gonna start off mentioning the animals that were on this list last year that I did actually get to own, or that I do own. So like I said, Zero was on that list and I got him. A Cuban Night Anole was on that list and I now have Percy, my Cuban Night Anole, or Perseus, which is his actual name, but I was calling Percy for short. And in my top three was a chameleon, because I've wanted a chameleon since I saw Tangled, because I am basic like that. And I have Eugene now. And I think Eugene was actually the first animal I got after I made that video. So it was like, finally got that dream reptile. Chameleon. Decade I waited for a chameleon. So now we're gonna go into my top 10 dream reptiles. That's kind of my herp wish list for Christmas. Now when I say that, I don't mean that I'm getting herps for Christmas. My family and my boyfriend would never go out and get me reptiles because I already have a lot. Now, just like last year, these are in no particular order, except I'm saving my top three for last. So I'm gonna name 10, and the last three I name are gonna be my absolute top three dream reptiles. So number one on the list, just kind of matching zero here, is a tri-colored hognose. They are my absolute favorite species or morph of hognoses, and I would kill for one. Next on the list, I'll kind of mention the frogs. So I really want a Pac-Man frog. I've been saying for the last year that every expo I go to, I'm gonna get a Pac-Man frog, and I never do, but I'd love a Pac-Man frog, especially a blue one. You guys know I love blue animals. And then going off of that would be milk frogs. Milk frogs are my favorite frogs. I can't wait for the day when I have milk frogs. I got to work with them during one of my internships at a zoo, and they were my favorite part of the internship. I just love milk frogs so much. They're so pretty and they're so cute. Okay, next would be leaf-tail geckos. I can't give you a specific species because I just really, really like all the leaf-tail geckos. I just want them all. So leaf-tail geckos I'll definitely have in the future. Flying gecko. I think they're just like the most epically cute gecko of all time. I would love to have a flying gecko. A Woma python is something I've wanted for quite a few years now after I saw one at an expo and absolutely fell in love with it. So Womas have been on my list. A kind of recent addition to my list in the past year is a Vietnamese blue beauty, because again, I love blue animals and I think they're just absolutely gorgeous. And now we're gonna go into my top three. So number three would be a Grand Cayman hybrid iguana. So you can't legally own Grand Cayman iguanas, but there are Grand Cayman hybrids, which are totally legal. And Grand Cayman iguanas are one of my favorite iguanas. Not just because they're like the true blue iguana, but I love them. And I love iguanas. So I would love a Grand Cayman hybrid. In second place is a blue tree monitor. I want monitor species anyway, but the ultimate monitor that I want is a blue tree monitor. And then in number one, which I don't think changed at all from last year, is a sailfin dragon. Still number one in my heart, number one on my list, my someday reptile that I must absolutely have. No ifs, ands, or buts. I will have a sailfin dragon one day. Even if it takes forever, I will have one someday. Okay. So that is my herp wish list. Let me know in the comments what your top three wants are when it comes to herps. What are your dream herps? What are the herps you absolutely would love to have one day? I mean, it's Christmas time, so this is the time for making wish lists, so why not? So as always, thank you guys so much for watching, and we'll see you for the next video.